Hello, and welcome to another episode of Virtual Flight Diaries. Thought I would take a break from VATSIM flights, and a buddy of mine suggested that I do some biplanes, so I thought, why not recreate a historical airmail route in New Jersey? So, I don't know how exactly accurate this is, but Microsoft Flight Simulator wouldn't let me start the flight where I wanted to start it, which was over to Stone Harbor, because the historical airmail route is from Stone Harbor to Ocean City. So the nearest one I got is Paramount Air, and I thought, well, it's a grass strip in Jersey, so why don't we, you know, start from there. So we're gonna say that we flew the mail down from Philadelphia, and this is gonna be one of our refueling stops. So we're gonna load the plane up, get our mail, get our fuel. Go full fuel here. Should be enough to actually do the whole run. So I'm going to take off from Paramount Air and then fly east to Stone Harbor. Now the planes would land on the beach at Stone Harbor, so that's where we're going to do. We're going to do a beach landing. We're going to do our mail exchange, and then we're going to fly up to Ocean City, New Jersey, and land on the beach there. So this historic route began in 1912. Just 9 years after the Wright brothers flew in Kitty Hawk. So, I mean, aviation was seriously in its infancy. The plane that flew the first route in 1912 was a pusher-type plane and looked similar to the Wright Flyer. Pusher type meant that the engine's propellers were in the back and pushed the plane into the air. So we're fast forwarding to after World War I, where there was lots of Curtis Jennings, the JN-4, which is nicknamed the Jenny, and lots of pilots from the war that, you know, had nothing better to do than be daredevils. So a lot of them joined the Flying Circus, Barnstormers, and of course the infancy of the U.S. Mail Air Service. And one of the routes that was flown was this one. Basically, Stone Harbor to Ocean City. So I'm going to say, so I titled my stream 1915. I'm going to say this is more like 1919. So here we are at Paramount Air in a very gloomy day. So for obvious things, this was wood and fabric that was doped, more like an epoxy resin. They called it dope. And then painted. So this was wooden cloth with an engine, so pretty much a flying kite. And it didn't have much to it. As you can see, we'll get inside. That's the panel. We have an altitude gauge, a oil gauge, an RPM gauge, and an outside temperature gauge. It was two batteries, which ran a light, and was push the button to start. Ran a light and cool. Someone put a little iPhone in here. Can we shut that off? I want it to really not happen. Apparently this livery has a little iPhone. Oh well. We're not going to use that because it didn't have a compass. It had a compass, a pocket compass, and a map. So this livery is from the 1957 movie with Jimmy Stewart, well, Charles Lindbergh. And Charles Lindbergh was very instrumental in furthering aviation, U.S. mail service. So, I thought it would be a nice touch to... I found this livery, and I'm like, oh, this is from that movie. Great movie. Got very bad reviews, but I liked it. I actually own a copy of it. So, let's get started here. So, the way this plane worked... This was the magneto contact. Pushed in, it disengaged. So you could spin the prop and the engine wouldn't start. So what they would do is you would be in the cockpit and there would be a guy out here. And you would yell fuel on and he would spin the prop and prime the engine. So you turn the prop, prime the engine to fuel, and then you would yell contact, and then you would pull this out, which then would bring the magnetos in contact with the cylinders, and then he would hand start the prop. The Curtis Jenny had exposed cylinder heads, and it was a 90 horsepower engine. A top speed of 75 miles an hour. So it's also a tail dragger with no tail wheel, so taxiing was odd. It couldn't taxi, so the crew would attach a little wheel cart to the back and they would push the plane out onto the runway. Well, let's get started for our first leg. We're going to head over to Stone Harbor, just across the Cape May Point here. And it's a little gloomy, a little dark, so we're going to turn our lamp on. Stick my head out the side to see where we're going because the nose up attitude. Do a flight controls check. All cables and bolts. This also did not have any brakes. Throttle. Does it come down? Tail came up. Got up the speed or just lifted into the air. We're gonna hold this attitude here for a little bit, get some altitude. Head out over to the Delaware Bay here. This grass strip is just above the distance, if you know South Jersey. I guess the villas. So this is just above the villas. Head down. Right now we're heading down towards the Cape May Lewis Ferry. We're not gonna go down that far. Actually, turn over east. Head over to our first stop. Much a kite with an engine. Alright, so I'm gonna lift my head up so I can see a little better. I'm gonna turn this out here. Not so much. GPS, so I'm going to put on a little map here. They would have had a road map. There's no aeronautical charts. Too far north. If they exposed the cylinder heads, you can see the valve lifters moving. Pretty cool model. It's one of the airplanes that actually comes with flight simulator. It's modeled okay. I'm not sure. I've never flown a Jenny before, so I don't know if it's exact. It's decent. Not too difficult. There's no autopilot, so I have to trim it out, put my hand on the controls. I mean, I can let go for a little bit because I would trim it out pretty good, but it tends to drift. So we're coming down towards Wildwood, or north of Wildwood. And grass is sound over there. You can fly very high. I'm about 500 feet, maybe. Maybe less. And then off to our left, off to our right is North Wildwood. Anglesey is off our nose. Hereford Inlet. So this was, they flew this low because everything was pure visual preference. They had to see the ground. And if you notice, some older buildings have town names painted on the roofs. That was for these planes, so we knew, oh, I'm flying over Anglesey because the town general store has Anglesey written on it. You know, that's how you knew where you were, so you could pinpoint yourself on the map. Later on, and thanks to the efforts of Charles Lindbergh and other airmail pilots and the U.S. government, they started a network of beacon lights that were used for night flying. So the pilots would fly beacon to beacon at night. You could deliver the mail 24 hours a day. There's Stone Harbor Point. Alright, so we're going to come down over the beach. We're going to land on the beach. We're going to shut down. Do a mail exchange. I'm going to take off and head to Ocean City. And we're probably going to, you know, there's an airport in Ocean City. We're probably going to land on the beach there because the original airmail route had been landing on the beach as well. That first plane in 1912 had skids on it, didn't have wheels at all. So it was very pretty simple. There's no flaps, you just power back. Oh no! Came in too fast. Alright, well, happens. Let's restart it. We'll do it again.
Couldn't find valid airport data at this position. Services are not available.
Technical difficulties? Should have put back into the cockpit view. It's fine for my visual view. Couldn't tell my angle. Okay. Take off, we'll fly over there, and we'll do this again. Wonders of flight simulator. And to bring a point, that happened a lot. A lot of pilots died in this early age of flight. Fairly historically accurate. We'll get it this time. That was my fault. Came in a little too fast and didn't have my angle right. I needed to be in this view instead of this view. I like flying in this one, so I can see a little better. Airport. Not very forgiving of planes. They had, like I said, no flaps. It was real stick and rudder. Flies nice. Landing at an airport is difficult. I had no brakes. We'll come back in over North Wildwood, making the attempt at our Green Harbor stop. Interesting enough, a lot of these planes were lubricated with castor oil. And that castor oil would spray back as a mist. We all know what happens if you ingest castor oil. It was often used back then as a as a laxative. Imagine a lot of pilots landed in farm fields to knock on the door and say, hey, use your facility. Out properly. But clean. Site. breezy out here over the beach. See, guys, I told you to do it. Like I said, there's no brakes. Just pull back on it, drive those wheels into the sand, put the sand to kind of slow us down. Okay. The fuel off. We are. Stone Harbor Beach. Let's see how much fuel we burned. Oh wow, we burned a lot of fuel. Alright, so I take on some more fuel. Fix our center of gravity. And take on some more mail. And then we're gonna head up to Ocean City. All right, so fuel on, contact off. Spin it around. Ready? Contact. Wave to our crew guy. Off we go. Lined up. Hopefully the terrain is forgiving enough to get off the ground. Did it. Gain some speed. Good. Sneak out over the water. Keep an eye on the beach. Views of our lovely plane flying out over the ocean. Horrible rendition of Avalon. But looks cool enough, right? So, the airmail guys, they just follow the coastline up to Ocean City. Just a little bit, some speed. So, like I said, this is a kite with an engine on it, so the wind and the breeze and everything is definitely fighting this. Pretty much flying as fast as a car would drive this route. And these airmail guys were crazy. They were wind, snow, and when the U.S. mail services were delivering, wind, rain, snow, anything short of a hurricane. They were delivering the mail. There was no radar, you know, radios. Literally flew by the seat of your pants. Just a few hundred feet off the ground. But there's also no regulations, so you need a place to sleep, land down into a field, curled up underneath your wing. And these guys would fly all over the country, especially the barnstormers and the flying circus guys. Let's see if we could find Ocean City out of the way. Just like they would do, looking at the terrain. I can imagine with all these wires that would make a really cool hum noise. So the first flight in 1912 took that little airplane 29 minutes to do the mail. Go 19 miles. Figure out how fast it was going. The plane's behaving, I want to say the wind's coming from the coast. Seems like we're getting blown out to sea. just watched a documentary today about how instrumental also that Charles Lindbergh was in. Involved in the 30s, the start of TWA Airlines, which started out as TAT, Transcontinental Air Transport. Used the Ford tri-motor, which is a plane that's modeled in place by the United Airlines, so there might be another classic flight go back to a California one. Something to think of that. Long Beach to Long Beach Airport, which was an airport company used by Howard Hughes. Ford tri-motor action. It's a classic plane. Nose pointed for how long towards the shoreline, and we're still out to sea. It's going to make for an interesting landing on the beach up by Ocean City. Not sure, because the landmass is here. Microsoft has to use Microsoft's products, so we use Bing. In my opinion, Bing is not very good. Wish they could use Google Maps. Now, there's a Google Maps mod that does make things look a little better. Really messes with the simulator. Almost have to do a complete reinstall to get rid of thinking that's the airport. So we made the trip a little faster than that 1912 trip. Because I guarantee you that plane was only doing 2 miles an hour. Beach to land on. Not gonna go too far. Keep the power. Stall out. We need to go further down the beach. Give ourselves more room to line up. Ground too. Good box pattern. Straight beach, so give ourselves a little. It'd be really cool if someone did a scenery mod for Jersey Shore points, you know, for boardwalks. No good at scenery building or even painting and, you know, textures on planes and stuff like that for a flight simulator. The last time I did texture modification was FS2000. This wasn't a very aerobatic plane, so we had to definitely want to stall out. Get the air on the beach. Come back. inside the cockpit. Try not to land in the water. Did it again. Well, that was our attempt at this. We landed at Stone Harbor.
Juliet Yankee 04, traffic November Charlie 566 Sierra, taking off runway 32 straight out departure.
Right, we're not going to do the flight over. Definitely, definitely not as easy as it looks. But I thank everyone for watching. I have to get going. Some things to do. So I hope you enjoyed. You know, the scenic views and our attempts to land on the beach, but we couldn't make it this round. So thank you for watching, and till next time, bye.